Hey everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to show you how to create this flowing water liquid effect in your text to animate it. We're going to start off by creating a new composition and typing in our text. So after you've typed in your text, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create an outline for it. And make sure the outline or the stroke color is also white. What I'm going to do right now is duplicate this layer, and in the bottom layer, I am going to turn the fill to the background color. In the second duplicated layer on which we're going to apply the effects, what I'm going to do is turn off the stroke. For now, I'm going to turn off the bottom layer and we're going to start applying the effects. The first thing we're going to do is create a rectangle shape. Now we're going to position it. So for this rectangle, you're going to turn on the position stopwatch, and at the end of your timeline, you're going to move it upwards so that it covers your entire text, just like this. So now what I'm going to do is, in the track matte option of the text, you're going to turn it into alpha matte shape layer 1, which is basically your rectangle. Now at the halfway mark, you can see this is the effect you're getting. Now we're going to search for turbulent displace and apply it to our shape layer. So this is what your text looks like for now. We're going to change a few values here. Change the amount to 150 and we're going to turn on the evolution. You're going to press down on the Alt key and turn the evolution stopwatch on. And here you're going to type in time *250. The next effect that we're going to apply is the roughen edges effect. Here you're going to increase the border to around 30, increase the scale to around 170, and what I'm going to do now is pre-compose the top two layers. On the pre-compose layer, we're going to apply the fill effect, and here you can change the color to the color of water. So for example, this color. Then what I'm going to do is duplicate this layer twice and I'm going to change the fill color to a lighter blue in one layer, and in one of the other layers I'm going to change it to white. Then the last step that you're going to do is grab one of these timelines and move it a couple of frames forward. What this will do is create this effect for you. The last thing I'm going to do is reduce the rough edges a little. So in the roughen edges effect that you applied, make sure the fractal influence is turned to zero. That way, when you go towards your main composition and play it, you can see that you have a more smooth effect, just like this one. The reason why I kept the outlines on is because if you want this effect with the outlines of the water filling up, then you can generate this as well. This is how easily you can create a water effect on any text that you want. If you're interested in more Adobe After Effects tutorials, please make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I will see you guys in my next video. Take care. Bye.